This video is sponsored by Squarespace, the best way to make an amazing website. Ever since Apple announced their 2-year transition from Intel CPUs to their very own custom silicon for the Mac, everyone's been wondering just how much those new Apple Silicon chips will change the Mac. So in this video, I'm gonna explain just some of the ways we can expect our Mac experience to improve. And based on all the research that I've done on Apple Silicon, I believe that these improvements are gonna be so great that the rest of the personal computing industry is gonna quickly follow in Apple's footsteps. So before we get into the game-changing improvements, let me start off by explaining exactly what Apple Silicon is and what's so great about it. Apple Silicon simply means a chip designed by Apple using the RISC instruction set, which Apple is licensing from ARM. So if you own a modern iPhone or iPad, it already has an Apple Silicon chip in it, like the iPhone 11's A13 Bionic chip or the iPad Pro's A12Z chip. So essentially, Apple Silicon Macs will come loaded with the same type of chip that you already have in your iPad. But Apple did confirm that these chips will be built from the ground up, specifically with the Mac in mind. That means they can be larger and they could be more powerful, since the batteries built into MacBooks are much larger than the ones that are built into iPhones or iPads. Apple even went as far as to say that there will be a specific Apple Silicon chip built for every Mac enclosure. So the 16-inch MacBook Pro will get a more powerful chip compared to a 13-inch MacBook Air. Now you might be asking, how in the world can one of these simple iPad chips possibly compete with current x86 Intel chips? Well, the current high-end $1,800 13-inch MacBook Pro with Intel's brand new 10th gen 10 nanometer processor is already getting outperformed by the iPad Pro's A12Z chip in terms of both the processor and graphics performance. And later this year, we're expecting the new A14X chip, which is 2 generations newer. And that's just the iPad Pro chip, not the brand new family of chips going into the Mac, which are going to be even more powerful. And for the higher end Macs, Apple is also utilizing various hardware accelerator chips to help boost performance for specific tasks. So I'm fairly confident that performance is not going to be an issue for Apple Silicon Macs, but the real game changer actually has to do with the quality of life improvements. So let's think about how your current computer, Mac, or laptop in general runs right now. They're fairly reliable, but sometimes they start to slow down, so you have to restart it to get it to run fresh again. Waking from sleep can sometimes take a few seconds, and driver issues are common, especially for the graphics card. Battery life isn't great either, whether for standby or in general, rarely reaching Apple's advertised 10 hours of battery life on most MacBooks. Some apps run great, but others just aren't very optimized, and sometimes the Mac can crash out of nowhere. Now think about how your iPhone or your iPad runs. They're incredibly reliable, rarely ever crashing unless you have an older model with a degraded battery. You rarely ever have to restart your iPhone due to it running slowly. iPhone and iPads are always on, so waking from sleep literally happens instantly, unlike a Mac. With an iPad, you can actually get close to or surpass Apple's rated battery life, unlike on a Mac. Most apps are optimized to run very well and reliably, since Apple has a set of standards for each app. And Apple software does an excellent job at power management and multitasking, allowing an iPhone SE with only 3 gigs of RAM to run great. There are no driver issues since Apple controls all aspects of the hardware, from the processor to the graphics and to the RAM, which isn't the case on a Mac, especially the iMac with user replaceable RAM. So now let's imagine what a Mac will be like running on Apple Silicon and what other features we can expect this year and going into the future. But first, let me give a huge shout out to the sponsor of this video, Squarespace. If you've been thinking about making your own website, Squarespace is literally the best way to go. I built an engaging website for my wife's cleaning business with literally no web making experience. You just choose a template, customize blocks of text and images, and easily move them around. It's incredibly simple, affordable, and it's been running flawlessly for over 2 years, bringing in new clients thanks to its built-in SEO tools. So whether you're making a website for a small business or for literally anything else, go to squarespace.com for a free trial and use our custom link below when you're ready to launch to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or domain. Now, going back to Apple Silicon Macs, imagine never having to restart your Mac like you previously used to. Imagine the processor being always on, so waking up from sleep happens instantly instead of having to wait a few seconds at times. Imagine getting 15 to 20 hours of battery life, which is what most analysts are expecting from these new chips. And there are two main reasons for the extra battery life. Number one is that Apple controls both the software and the hardware with their excellent power management software, controlling and optimizing multitasking. Number two is that Apple Silicon chips come with a mixture of high performance chips and efficiency chips. So when you're doing light tasks, like browsing the web, the powerful chips are actually completely turned off, significantly improving battery life. And thanks to Apple adding hardware accelerators, you'll be able to play high definition 4K videos without putting a heavy load on the processor, saving even more battery life. And thanks to the simple RISC instruction set, there's way less overhead compared to traditional x86 chips, which have to support a bunch of outdated technologies. Imagine no longer running into driver issues with AMD graphics, since Apple Silicon Macs will be using Apple graphics from now on, which they fully control. Imagine your MacBook no longer getting super hot, reaching up to 100 degrees Celsius like the 2020 MacBook Air did, literally while just browsing the web. Imagine your MacBook's fans not maxing out and sounding like an airplane while doing simple things like being on a Zoom call, which is exactly what many people complained about on the MacBook Air. The new Apple Silicon Macs will no longer have those overheating issues. And what makes it even better is that many of the features that we currently have on our iPhone and iPad can be very easily added to Apple Silicon Macs. We should definitely expect Face ID to come on the Mac, making logging in and purchasing things online more convenient than ever before. This also means facial recognition features will come as well, like the Memoji features and other great possibilities, like getting an instant green screen feature for streamers and content creators. We should expect LTE cellular service to come with the Mac in the future. Perhaps the best thing is that the massive library of iPhone and iPad apps are gonna be available on Apple Silicon Macs, and Apple already has technology in place which automatically translates touch input to mouse input on the Mac. So that means your favorite games like Call of Duty Mobile will be available to play on the Mac with game controller support, which is gonna enable crossplay between various Apple devices. And other apps like Facebook, Instagram, Netflix, Reddit, all of that is coming to the Mac. Apple is also most likely working on new handoff features that allow you to instantly switch from using your Mac to using your iPhone or your iPad, which is only becoming available because the architecture is being shared for the first time ever. And the best part is that these new Macs are expected to be priced the same or possibly less expensive than the previous Intel models, so you're getting all of those improvements for less cash than before. And since Apple no longer has to rely on Intel and AMD for performance improvements, and Apple instead controls every aspect of the hardware, we know that we'll get consistent performance improvements every year, just like we already get for the iPhone. So the point that I'm trying to make is that Apple's upcoming Macs are about to become much more reliable, they're gonna get much better battery life, they're gonna be packed with much more features, and they're gonna fit into Apple's ecosystem better than ever before. They're gonna run cooler, quieter, longer, and more reliably than ever before, and they might even get less expensive than the current Intel models. So based on all of that, I believe that people are gonna be blown away by the Apple Silicon Macs. And here's how I personally think things are gonna play out. Apple's gonna announce their new Apple Silicon Macs with impressive specs for the price. And once reviewers start getting their hands on these new Macs, they'll be impressed with just how well they run. They'll try out a few iOS apps and be shocked at how well the automatic touch-to-click input translation works. And they'll be even more impressed by the battery life. Consumer satisfaction and reliability surveys will start to favor Apple devices thanks to all the stability improvements due to Apple controlling both the software and all aspects of the hardware. Once Apple starts to add more features like Face ID, LTE service, and things like that, more and more Windows users will begin switching over to these new Apple Silicon Macs. More and more game developers will begin creating games for Apple devices since they all run using the same chip architecture. So the code base is now shared, leading to much less coding work to reach a larger audience. The entire personal computing industry is going to be shaken, with companies realizing that this is the future of personal computing. Microsoft will invest everything they have into getting an ARM-based version of Windows running as soon as possible, but it won't work nearly as well as Apple's because Microsoft can't control both the software and the hardware at the same time. And Apple will stay ahead for years since they have such a good relationship with TSMC, reserving most, if not all, of their best-in-class 5-nanometer silicon wafer yield that is used to build these new Apple Silicon Mac chips. Most laptops, starting with the thin and light segment, will eventually run using ARM-based chips built by AMD and Intel instead of the current x86 chips, but I think that Intel is going to be a little bit late to the game. The point that I'm trying to make with all of this is that Apple is going to revolutionize the personal computing industry starting later this year. And in terms of when Apple will announce the very first Apple Silicon Macs, there are two different possibilities. Number one is that they'll announce them at the iPhone event next month, which is rumored to happen on October 13th. But if they also announce a bunch of other products like the AirTags, the AirPods Studio, and the AirPower charging mat, then I'm not sure if it makes sense to also announce the MacBooks at the same time. Because if they do, they're gonna overwhelm the consumers, and many people are gonna have to choose between buying a new iPhone or the AirPods Studio or buying a new Apple Silicon MacBook. So there's also the chance that Apple is gonna have another event, possibly at the end of October or early November, dedicated to the Apple Silicon Macs and potentially a new Apple TV or a new iPad Pro. So I guess we're just gonna have to wait and see what happens next month. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, go ahead and tap the like button and click the circle above to subscribe for more videos like this one. And if you wanna see some more Apple Silicon videos, you can check them out right over there. And be sure to check out our Apple Silicon ARM shirt down in the merch shelf below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.